Good morning, everybody, and welcome to day two of our Singapore adventure.
Now, it is known as one of the most expensive countries in the world, so today we're going to show you everything that we spend and try and do a realistic budget.
So we're not going to literally go in 7-Eleven, eat rice and sit in a park and do nothing the whole day, but obviously we're not going to splurge out in nice restaurants, so we're actually going to show you, I guess, how you can still enjoy yourself, eat some local food, do some nice activities, but do it on a bit of a backpacker's budget. I did not think I'd be doing an activity like this.
Don't want the owners to hear what we have to say. It is actually horrible. Anyway, we're heading to our first stop of the day, which is actually outside of Chinatown, so we need to get the MTR.
Getting a taxi, no?
No, we're getting the
budget.
The metro, yeah. The metro there, so we'll show you how cheap that is as well.
Oh my god, someone had a motorbike, a sidecar, a person and two dogs. That's the best thing I've seen in Singapore in 2 days. So we're just on our way to Maxwell Tube or Train Station and we're going to East Coast Park, which is going to be super exciting. But we haven't actually got one taxi or Grab or Uber the whole time we've been in Singapore, and it's really cool because you get to see like all the street art, taking the sights and the smells of the city, and obviously it is so much cheaper getting public transport. So yeah, really easy to get around and cheap in Singapore.
Today we decide to leave the bustling tourist spots behind and venture across the city to explore a laid-back local area recommended to us by a friend who used to live here.
So we have just literally got off the train at Marine Parade and there is a very bustling local food market here straight away, so why not?
We like coffee, yeah.
Think we'll get a coffee to fuel ourselves for the activity that is about to commence.
Yeah.
So this one has the biggest queue called Coffee Queen and it looks like they do iced coffee for like $1.50, so proper bargain.
Thank you.
$1.80 for one large iced coffee. We didn't even plan on coming here, but it's a great way to start the day. If you ever see any of these markets around Singapore, this is where you're going to get like good food, but more budget than the swanky restaurants in the city.
It's good, but not Vietnam coffee, but it's good.
What's funny in these food halls is you have to clear your trays by law.
After our caffeine boost kicked in, we walked just 5 minutes around the corner and found ourselves in one of the city's most breathtaking parks. A beautiful oasis with winding trails and lush scenery that felt like stepping into another world. So we've headed to East Coast Park because we heard it's got a beautiful cycling track.
You're going the wrong way, love.
Oh, okay. This way. Heard it's got a beautiful cycling track all along the coastline with like loads of obviously parks and beaches, etc. But we now need to find a place to hire a bicycle.
This place is proper cool though, like there's so many people sitting down
having
picnics, people on the cycle track, people walking and running and exercising.
Yeah, and then there's a beach right here next to us as well.
Yeah, although there's also a lot of shipping containers and stuff in the water, but the beach itself, like if you was to just look at the beach, it would be
pretty nice. There's also a group of people playing volleyball on a small bit of the beach. It's really cool, isn't it?
It's cool.
It's like a mixture of a park, a beach.
I think this is one thing that Singapore does really well, and I know we touched on it on our last video, so you should obviously check that out. But they really do a lot to like promote exercise and green spaces and healthy activity.
Yeah.
Which to be fair, I'm all about.
Yeah, and we love that, don't we? What are these guys doing?
They're doing Pankat Silat.
Martial arts.
Or Kali. So fairly reasonable, costs $10 per bicycle for an hour. So obviously we've got two. Do you want that one?
Whatever.
Well, I'll take this one.
Yeah, we're gonna ride along now and see what we can find in this park, but great activity, I think, for an okay-ish price. Not budget, but also.
I think we should go that way though, because we walked that way.
You wanna go that way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. It's an absolutely beautiful day as well for cycling, isn't it? Like the perfect park day or park weather.
Fantastic getting a bit of exercise in.
and watching everyone just go about like a nice lazy Sunday, something we would do back in the UK as well. Yeah, it's lovely to be out of the touristy areas of Singapore and exploring a bit more of the local side of the country.
Yeah, look at that. Long Beach.
I'm not gonna lie, when I heard we was coming to Singapore, I did not think I'd be doing an activity like this.
Yeah.
Like on a Sunday, like out in the nature or as naturey as you can be, cycling along, soaking up the vibes. Whew.
Lots of fishermen. Oh God.
And just from the end of the jetty, we can see a nice view of the Singapore city landscape. So I can just make out
Marina Bay Sands.
Marina Bay Sands. I can see the Ferris wheel and everywhere we was obviously checking out yesterday, which is pretty cool actually to know we've come this far out of the city.
Yeah, we are far away, aren't we?
And it feels like we've got a lot closer to the airport, like the planes seem a lot closer, although you can't see them on the camera.
Yes.
But yeah, we've also got 20 minutes till our bikes need to be back.
Right, let's go.
A speedy dash back to the bike rental place, and it's time for some lunch.
Look guys, we know how hard it is to plan your trips. It is literally my full-time job. That's why we create epic days like today. But we wanted to make it super easy and convenient for you guys to do that, so we've created our ultimate travel planner and guide. At the moment, we've got 7 countries of travel guides in there, and every time we visit a new country, we update it. It's got stuff like top hostels, top food to try, useful information, all of the stuff you need to know to explore a new country. Plus, the travel planner is a place for you to put all of this information into one spot, so your itinerary, packing list, all that kind of stuff is all in one document. If you're interested, check out the link in the description, and if you've got any questions, drop them in the comments down below or DM us on Instagram. Anyway, back to the video.
So we've got the tube back over to Chinatown now because we are going back to the food hawker food centre we went to yesterday. We're going to get different food, and the reason why we've come to this one and not a new one to show you is because there's a activity or a cheap thing to do here that we're going to show you after our lunch.
We needed to get cash out, as a lot of some of them do take card, but the ones that we want don't. So you can only get $50 out, which is a little bit annoying, but probably spend it all today. And they charge you $5 at the hawker centre, so naughty. Thank you.
Yeah. $46.
Okay. Thank you. $4, and we've got a nice little refreshing lime juice each. Are you drinking it? What are you doing? It's the wrong way. God.
One thing we love about hawker centres is that every time we sit down to eat, a friendly local starts chatting to us.
Why does it look like you're about to drop it?
I do.
Good choice.
Yeah?
No,
good choice?
Yeah. Your friend is very good.
Good? Ah, good. I've got a duck pork combo and a soup. Yeah?
Oh yeah, how much is that then?
$7.
Oh, good.
Try the soup.
It's good value as well.
Yeah, tasty. Yeah. I don't know what's in the soup, but it tastes nice. Like a vegetable broth?
The
cabbage soup.
Cabbage soup.
Nice. Have you ate that before? Yeah. It's like duck and pork and soy sauce.
Woohoo.
Nice. Yeah, really crispy. The outside soft in the middle. And this one is very sweet. It's got a sweet sauce.
So it's not duck then?
There is some duck in it. But I've also got like really crispy pork. A bit like pork scratching with pork on it. So this is my favourite place to come and eat in Singapore.
I decided to treat myself to an Indian thali for just $7.
We've got 4 curries here. So it looks like a chana masala, some sort of aubergine one, a vegetable dal, and then a green spinachy one. I think 2 people could easily eat this, and it looks delicious, so let's give it a taste. It's going to be a big lunch, and we need it after that bike ride.
So who doesn't enjoy a nice cold pint after a day of sightseeing, a cycling adventure? And I actually spotted this place yesterday that has potentially one of the best happy hours that I have seen in my life.
No,
it is super cheap. Well, for Singapore anyway. So yeah, we're gonna go and try and see if we can find that and check it out. could not care less about somebody singing. I just want to go get a pint.
No, I was going to say the fun part about Singapore is no matter where you walk in whatever time, there's always going to be something free and fun to do.
I mean,
like,
I love
watching a show like that. That's quite cool. I know some guys just sat around playing checkers. You just mooch around. You don't even have to spend money. You could just walk around and soak it all in, which is really cool.
So this place here does $3 pints of beers, I think until 3 p.m. and then the price like goes up a dollar every hour. But it's so reasonable. What's that, £1.50, £2 for a beer. And yeah, it's absolutely rammed as well. Cheers.
And as I cannot drink beer, I'm going to get a glass of Chardonnay, which is $7.80. And do you know what we're going to do here, guys? We're going to play Monopoly Deal and watch all of the people walk past, which is a great way to pass the time for a very cheap drink. So we're happy.
One thing about Gaz and me is that we're both really competitive with each other. So here's my winning dance. And after another game of cards...
Just turning the camera on to watch... A pretty regular occurrence in this relationship.
You're joking me. I literally won the last game.
I'll be getting annoyed when I win.
And then, right. You literally just did the exact same thing, so I don't know what you're talking about.
One. Loser. Now winning dance. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Cheers. $12.95, that is.
Garden.
Oh, I'll tell you what, if we had two beers, it would be six.
Now we've had a glass of wine and beer, it's on to the accommodation tour. Now I'm going to do it round the corner from where we live because I don't want the owners to hear what we have to say. However, to put into context, me and Gaz spent days trying to find anything within our budget that was a private room. We even tried to look at our Amex points, and to be honest, it was really expensive. So we've settled on where we are now, which is Wanderluft Capsule Hostel. I'll show you inside, show you the bed, etc. It's the best of a bad bunch, right in the middle of Chinatown. It is about a 9-minute walk from a metro station, about a 15-minute walk from the Merloyen statue, and you can get pretty much anywhere, so it's super central, and that's what drew us to this place, because we could have got cheaper and probably nicer, but it would have been further out of town. So yeah, anyway, we'll sneak inside. I imagine there is rules on filming in there, so we'll try and do it sneaky sneaky. And welcome to my humble abode. So we have a double capsule bed. We've been here 2 nights, so it's a bit of a mess, but we're quite impressed by our hanging system, so we don't have to go in and out of the locker every 5 minutes. We've got a plug and a light. Duvet, towels, and we're on the top bunk. This cost us 72 Singaporean dollars, which is around £40 for both of us, so £20 each, so it's actually quite a good price. We obviously used to our own rooms, but you know, when needs must, we'll take it.
The funniest part of the hostel was the sheer number of signs plastered everywhere. If you had a thought, a question, or even something you might do wrong, there was a sign for it. They covered every wall, making it feel very strange. Toilets were clean enough and did the job. Now on to this evening's activities.
Gaz is worrying he's got someone else's bloody sliders on.
They don't feel usual.
They don't feel like me, he said. Anyway, we've had a few hours of chill in the hostel, packed up our bags because we're heading to our next country tomorrow, and one we've already visited, so have a guess down in the comments below. We're now heading out for some dinner, and it wouldn't be a full day of spending if we didn't show you what we had for food, so we'll do a full cost right at the end, and let's go grab some dinner.
We are going, in case anybody wanted to know, to a place called La Passat, which is another hawker centre.
This one is a lot larger than the other one we went to. It's got like little different areas. There's an outdoor seating area. And yeah, it looks a lot more modern. So even just by the way that their shops are presented, the seats have got like big wooden tables, big fans above. It just feels like a lot posher than what we've been to. But the food looks delicious. Similar kind of vibe to the other one. Any cuisine you ever want under the sun. Malay, Chinese, Indian, anything Asian you can get. So we're just gonna have a little scout around and choose what we want for dinner.
So I've got Thai food, Penang chicken, was $7.50, which is quite cheap to be fair. I think there was like too much choice. Like, I just couldn't decide to try it anyway. I mean, the sauce tastes nice, but there's lots of like floppy chicken skin in it. So it's not my favourite, but it's good. I feel like a bit under pressure.
And mine is what it says on the tin. A butter chicken with rice. Now, I think I should have got a set menu because this is like a huge portion of rice and this is a huge portion of curry. So there's no way I'm going to eat all this to myself. $10, not bad. Let's give it a taste. It is actually horrible. It's like substitute meat. The sauce is all, it doesn't taste like butter chicken and the rice feels overcooked. But I think that's just a wrong choice. Like the atmosphere here, maybe we should have gone for like the Singaporean dishes, like the chicken and rice, etc. So that's my own fault, but I'm not going to recommend that Indian to you guys at all. I'm highly disappointed. I'm not going to eat it.
It actually takes a lot for me to not like something. So that says a lot about that horrible curry I just had.
I'm running because we're getting an ice cream.
But to end on a high note, we headed to the quay to grab some ice cream and enjoy Singapore's breathtaking skyline. The stunning views were the perfect way to lift our spirits.
So in total, we have spent this amount. I'll put it on the screen because our transport hasn't come through yet. We've got a good estimate of how much we think we've spent for the day, around $65 per person. Now that's quite good going for Singapore, I'd say. Obviously it's a bit more of a budget than anywhere else in Southeast Asia, well, a lot more of a budget, but we haven't really missed out on anything today. We've had a really, really good day. So if you've enjoyed this video, make sure you give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next one. We're in a country we've already been to, but we're doing completely new stuff, so it's going to be really exciting. Anyway, bye!